Well, it's a very interesting story intellectually. One of the dominant ideas which governs thinking since the 18th century is the idea that we can make everything to our pleasure, that we can design social institutions in their working. Now, that is basically mistaken. Social institutions have never been designed and do much more than we know. They have grown up by a process of selection of the successful without people frequently knowing why it was successful. That applies to the market. The market is most ingenious, but ingenious without having been designed, instrument which enables us to utilize knowledge which is distributed among hundreds of thousands of people. It's an adaptation to thousands of circumstances which nobody ever can know as a whole, and where the prices formed on the market tell the individual what to do and what not to do in the social interest. Now, in order to understand this, you have to know economics. To the naive person who imagines all the distribution of income is determined by somebody deliberately and actively, it seems that if this is the responsibility of a particular guy, this is evidently done very unjustly. The fact is, it's not being done unjustly because we achieve all that we do achieve by having come to agree to play a sort of game in which the game of the market, as I like to call it, in which, because we are utilizing more information, more facts than anybody knows, the outcome for a particular individual is necessarily unpredictable. Now, an outcome which is unpredictable and undesigned by anybody cannot be just as little as the outcome of a game of chance can be a just game. But people resent this, and the people who imagine, oh, it should be possible to design all this, to arrange this, accept the government to do this in a manner so that the distribution is just. Now, that is literally impossible, because it would require that all this widely dispersed information about particular facts and particular circumstances and particular gifts can be used and controlled by a central authority.
Why couldn't the role of the justice maker come at the end of a process by taking from someone who has more than he needs for the purpose of satisfying somebody who has less than he needs?
Because if he knows that part of his income is going to be taken from him, there's no inducement for him to do that particular thing. If I know that if I do a thing which will fetch a very high price, 2/3 of it are being taken from me, and I can do something much more pleasant for 1/3 of the income without paying any income tax, I'm going to do that and not going to do what's most beneficial to society.
Well, but in point of fact, a great many people who are taxed at the 2/3 rate continue to be very productive.
Well, I doubt whether they are as productive as they could be.
All right, but let's say they are less productive than they could be. But how do you answer the question that the demands of justice are perhaps approached after you have permitted a natural distribution of the proceeds through the market mechanism?
There are no possible rules of a just distribution in a system where the distribution is not deliberately the result of people bringing it about. I mean, justice is an attribute of individual action. I can be just or unjust towards my fellow man. But the conception of a social justice, to expect from an impersonal process which nobody can control to bring about a just result, is not only a meaningless conception, it's completely impossible. See, everybody talks about social justice, but if you press people to explain to you what they mean by social justice, what they would accept as just, nobody knows. I'm telling you, because I've been trying for the past 20 years asking people, what really are your principles of social justice?